In this lesson, we're going to learn Down by the Riverside. I'm going to show you the verse and the chorus. There's four chords in this tune, G, G7, D, and C. We're going to work on just a quarter note strum for this lesson. Make sure you're in tune and we'll get started. In our verse, we've got three chords and we're going to play a quarter note down strum throughout. And if you're working on your G chord, you've come to the right place. Here's a little bit of what it sounds like. One, two, three, four, and one. Down by the riverside. Now switch chords here. Down by the riverside. So on my fret hand, I've got three chords. You'd probably notice the G chord. I'm using three fingers, got my middle finger, third fret of low E, index finger, second fret of A, and my ring finger is the third fret of high E. I'll also use a D chord, standard D chord where you strum four strings down, and then we're also going to use a G7 chord at the end of this section, which will signal the next section. So G7, if this is new to you, is similar to a C chord shape, but we're stretching out a little bit. My ring finger's third fret of low E, my middle finger's second fret of the A string, and my index finger's playing the first fret of high E. Let's take a look at those chords from another angle. We've got our G chord. We'll use a standard D chord. And at the end of the section, we'll use G7. Let's walk through the form of the progression. It's an 8-bar form repeated, and so we're going to have a first and second ending. Now, once again, we're going to play a whole lot of G chord. Right now, we're going to just strum whole notes, so once per measure, and I'll cue you for when to change to the next chord. So G chord, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, D. G, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Stay on G, first time through. Now we're going to repeat. So G, 4, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, D chord, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, G chord, and G7, do you guys? And 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's the form. For my strum hand, I'm going to mark every beat with a quarter note down strum. So on that G chord, 1, 2, 3, I'll play 1, 2, 3, 4, just like that. You don't need to strum hard, just keep it steady and even. If you need to tap your foot, go for it. If you do a little chicken head, that's acceptable too. Alright? Let's try strumming through the form now. Same thing we just did, but with those quarter notes. Grab that G chord, I'll count you in. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, down by the riverside. Back to G, down by the riverside. Repeat, and G. Your verse. So in the chorus, we've got one new chord, but we'll use the same strum pattern. Here's a little bit of what it sounds like. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, second fret of D, and first fret of the B string for the C chord. Let's walk through the progression. It's similar to the verse in that it's an eight bar progression with a first and second ending, so we'll repeat. So the first time through at the very end, we'll grab a G7, which will transition us to the repeat. Don't worry, I'll walk you through a favorite change. Just to hold it for now so we get the form down. Grab a C chord, two measures on the C. One, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four, and one, two, and the G chord for two measures. Two, three, four, and one. Now the D chord for two measures. Two, three, four, and one. Going back to G for one measure. Now G7 for one measure. Two, back to C. We're repeating. Two, three, four, two, three, four, and G. Two, three, four, and two. D chord again for two. Two, three, four, and one, two, three. Now stay on G for two measures this time. Two, three, four. So for the strum hand, it's that same quarter note strum, so you know what to do there. So let's put it together. I'll count you in on the C chord. One, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four, two. Now switch to G and one, two, three, four. Switch to D and two, three, four. Here comes the G chord, G7 right here. So back to C for the repeat. Two, three, four, two, three, G chord, and one, two, three, your chorus. All right, let's put it together. We'll play through our verse section with the first and second ending, and then go to the chorus section with the first and second ending. Grab your G chord. I'll count you in. And one, two, three, and four. And one, two, three, four. Chords can be found in hundreds of songs, so spend some time perfecting them here. Have fun working on it, and we'll see you next time.